In this video, we're going to do a problem that deals with the Pythagorean Theorem. So, first of all, just as a reminder, in case you haven't seen it or it's been a while, this is what the Pythagorean Theorem states. In a right triangle, the sum of the squares of the lengths of the two legs is equal to the square of the length of the hypotenuse. That's a mouthful, but basically a right triangle means you have a 90-degree angle and the two sides on either side of that are called the legs. So you can see this would be leg one, and this could be called leg two. It doesn't matter which you call the first side and the second side. But those are the legs, and the long side is the hypotenuse. Often it's just written like this with the A, B's, and C's, and we'll call the legs, we'll have say that one leg has length A, and the other leg has length B, and then if the hypotenuse has length C, then A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So here's a problem. Let's say you have a right triangle. You can see I have sides X plus 6 and X plus 7. Those are the legs, and I have a hypotenuse of X plus 8. And it says find the lengths of the sides of the right triangle showed. So it wants to know all three sides. So we're going to use the Pythagorean Theorem, where you could think of this as your A, and this is your B, and this is your C. We know that A squared plus B squared equals C squared, where A is one of the length of one of the legs. So we've got X plus 6 squared plus X plus 7 squared equals X plus 8 squared. All right, this is going to take a lot of writing. So X plus 6 squared, remember, is X plus 6 times X plus 6. X plus 7 squared is X plus 7 times X plus 7. And X plus 8 squared is X plus 8 times X plus 8. So if we do the FOIL method here and add like terms, we're going to get X squared. I'm going to do the outer and inner terms. 6X plus 6X is going to give you a 12X plus 36. This one will be X squared plus the outer and inner are 7X plus 7X or 14X plus 7 squared is 49. That's going to be X squared plus the outer and inner terms are 8x and 8x, 16x plus 64. Now, let's simplify the left-hand side. We have X squared plus X squared. Those are the two like terms, so we have 2x squared. We have a 12x and a 14x, which is going to be 26x. And we have 36 and 49, which is going to be 85. On the left, on the right side, I have X squared plus 16X plus 64. All right, so we're going to have some X squared terms here. So let's get everything on one side of the equation equal to 0. So we're going to have to do 2X squared minus X squared, right, for this minus X squared to both sides. And we've got plus 26X minus 16X. And plus 85 minus 64 is going to equal 0. So I've got, combining like terms, I finally get X squared plus 10X plus 21 equals 0, which we have to factor. So we have X and X and 3 and 7. So we have X plus 3 equals 0 or X plus 7 equals 0. So X is negative 3 or X is negative 7. Now, be careful. X is negative, but X isn't one of the sides. What you have to do now is see if that makes sense given how the sides were defined. All right, so quick look up here. See how the sides were defined? We had an X plus 6 and an X plus 7 for the legs and an X plus 8. So we've got, see if it makes sense in that picture. This we had in x plus, let's see which one did we put first, x plus 6, x plus 7, x plus 8. All right, what would happen if I put in negative 3 for x? I would have negative 3 plus 6, that would be 3, and negative 3 plus 7, that would be 4, and negative 3 plus 8, that would be 5. Is the right triangle? And that works. So one possibility is that the sides are 3, 4, and 5. Okay, let's see if it works for x equals negative 7. All right, so if you put in negative 7 for x, this would be negative 1. That's not going to work out, so forget that. All right, so the question was, I believe, find the lengths of the three sides. Right here, 3, 4, and 5. It doesn't ask you for x. All right? What it says is find the lengths of the sides of the right triangle shown. So, doing all this work, we get 3, 4, and 5. We didn't know what the units were. If they were in inches or feet or something else, then we would have been a little bit more specific. But we weren't given the unit, so that's the answer to this problem. So there are two things. We're using Pythagorean theorem. We got two solutions. Both times x happened to be negative, but only one of them made sense when we used a negative number. So don't necessarily see a negative number and think the answer is incorrect. You have to go back to the original problem and see if it makes sense given the original information. Perhaps neither solution will work for x, or maybe both of them will be possibilities.